So what's amazing about walking the streets of London in the footsteps of the Great Fire is that you can really get a sense of what it must have been like in 1666, even if the architecture is so different now. You know, you've got these sort of glass and steel skyscrapers, and there are only these sort of tantalising hints of the London that was there before. They are still there. In the first episode, we went to Pudding Lane, and, you know, I'm sure a lot of your, you know, your listeners and your viewers will have been to Pudding Lane, and you look up the sign and maybe you take a little selfie, and you think, well, of course, it was around here this fire started. You've got the monument over there. And it wasn't on Pudding Lane. In fact, it's round the corner on what's now Monument Street. And there was a sort of a bit of historical detective work, I suppose, that went into finding that out.
Now, if there's one thing most of us know about the Great Fire of London, it's that it started in a bakery here on Pudding Lane. And that bakery was owned by a man called Thomas Farriner. And I want you to remember his name, because he was a tricky character and he could turn out to be the villain of this whole story. So here's the first question. Where was Thomas Farriner's bakery?
For centuries, the answer has been lost, but historian Dorian Gerhold has made an extraordinary new discovery. Incredibly, he's managed to pinpoint the precise location of where the fire actually started. The process was in some ways brilliant and in some ways incredibly simple, of really just overlaying a series of old maps. And this is quite a sort of an effective technique. And it's not the first time that this has been used for a big historical discovery, because, of course, Richard III being located in Leicester was pretty much a piece of desk-based map research. And the same is true here of finding out where Thomas Farriner's bakery was and where the Great Fire started. And we were able to find and chart literally onto the ground where this little L-shaped bakery was, and not only where the L-shaped bakery was, but where the yard at the back was, where the, you know, the kindling for the ovens was, and therefore almost to the spot where the spark, you know, that began the Great Fire first landed. And that was a really exciting experience, actually.
It's 3 p.m. on Saturday, the 1st of September, 1666. An ordinary Saturday at the end of what's been an exceptionally long, hot, dry summer, but also the last day before the whole of London was devoured by flames. And this area, which today we call Monument, would have looked very different. So forget the office blocks, the cars, the Portaloo down there. Forget all of this. This would have been narrow little streets full of people going about their business, getting their supplies and shopping in before the whole city shut down for the Sunday.
Well, the Great Fire ate London, devoured it. I mean, it left very, very little to be salvaged. It was a point at which everything changed.